The way I would describe Imam Malik in one title would be that he was a man of aura, a man of absolute respect, meaning, I don't mean that, I mean every scholar was a man of aura, but when I talk about Imam Malik, when you looked at him, even if you didn't know that he was an imam, his features strike you. And you find something inside of you forcing you to respect this man. We call this in Arabic haiba, an aura, the man of aura. He used to say, there is nothing more harder upon me in life than when I was asked a question about halal or haram, is this permissible or not? Because I am representing the hukam, the ruling of Allah Himself, the creator of the world. And he spent his whole life in Medina, Medina al-Sharif, Medina al-Munawwara, in the land of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He never left Medina al-Munawwara his entire life, only to Mecca when he went and did Hajj or Umrah. In fact, not only did he ever never leave Medina al-Munawwara in his life until he died, and he lived for 90 years. 90 years he lived. He never even rode on a camel or any transport vehicle in his entire life when he was living in Medina. Because in his wara, in his righteousness and love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and as a role model, he saw fitting in himself as the scholar of Medina to always have his feet stuck to the ground of the land where the body of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is buried. He saw it disrespectful as an imam representing his deen in the highest esteem to lift himself off the ground out of respect for the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam while his body was in the ground. Never in his life did he ever lift his legs off the ground. Can you imagine that? 90 years. Except when he went to Hajj or Mecca outside of Medina. A young man, the age of about 13 years old, in the time of Imam Malik, when Imam Malik was in his middle ages, a young boy by the age of 13, his mother from Mecca, his mother said to him, "My son, you are now well known. You have memorized the whole Quran and you have memorized hadith, and you have memorized poetry. I want to send you to Imam Malik to learn his adab, his character, before you learn his knowledge." So she got him ready, and she wrote a letter to the Prince of Mecca, the governor of Mecca, who happened to be her cousin, this woman's cousin. She wrote a letter to him to send a letter to the governor of Medina to go with her son to Imam Malik, basically to intercede for him, to become his teacher. So this young boy took this letter from his mother, from the governor of Mecca, and she packed him some food and sent him off. Young 13-year-old going through the deserts to Medina, seeking knowledge. He reached the governor of Medina and gave him the letter of the governor of Mecca. And the governor of Medina, his face changed. He started to sweat. The young boy looked at him and said, "What's wrong?" He said, "Wallahi, if the governor of Mecca asked me to walk barefooted in the middle of the desert with nothing on my head, it would be easier than for me to go to Imam Malik's house," because he had so much respect for him. So the boy innocently said to him, "Well, you don't have to go to him, make him come to you." He forgot that Imam Malik is not as simple as going to the officials, no way. So he laughed, the governor of Medina laughed, and he said, "Come on, let's go." So he went to Imam Malik's house. They knocked on the door, and the housemaid, the servant of Imam Malik, answered, and they asked for Imam Malik, the prince, the governor of Medina. She said to him, "Listen, if there is a religious question, right now is not the time. Write it on a paper and he will answer it for you. If you want to learn hadith, go to his circles of Daras, they'll be in a certain time. And if it's a government issue, this is not the time, there's another time for it." So the governor of Medina says, "I have a letter for him from the Prince of Mecca." So then a big, tall man, blonde, white, colored eyes, unexpected from the people of Medina, came to the door. So as I looked up at him, and the servant lady brought him a chair, he sat on it. And then he said, "What does the governor of Mecca want from me?" And the governor of Medina just gave him the paper without a word. When Imam Malik read this paper, he threw the paper away saying, "La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah." Has it come to this that knowledge now needs connections? He looked at the young boy, and the young boy said to him, "Aslah Allahu Shaykh." May Allah straighten the path of the Shaykh. out of respect, young boy. He said to him, I am a Qurashi. I am from the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now, basically, he obliged the imam to listen to him. You have to respect the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ana Qurashi. I have memorized the Quran at the age of 7. And your Muwatta, the whole of it, I've memorized it with this chain of narrations by the age of 10. My mother sent me here to learn from you. Imam Malik looked at him and said, Ya Ghulam, O young boy, ittaqillah, fear Allah, wajtanib al-ma'asi, and stay away from sins. If you do so, there will be something of your future if you apply these two advices. Does anyone know who the young boy was? So he was Imam Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i. He thought he wasn't going to be a Shafi'i.